Come on in, the door's open. You're early. I wasn't expecting you so soon. Just make yourself comfortable. I'm just freshening up. I hope you like the music. It's the song my wife and I got married to. But that's all over now. I'll just be a moment.
Diane.
Hello, Jack. Our song, really?
It's not what it looks like.
It looks like you're about to have sex with a prostitute.
It might be what it looks like, but let me explain.
Explain what? There are hundreds of dollars on the bedside table. You're at a motel in the middle of the day, and you're standing there in your underwear. Tell me.
You're not even supposed to be here. You're supposed to be at home, resting.
And you're supposed to be at work. Working.
I am working. There was a remodeling job being done in my office. I was finding it difficult to concentrate, and so I came here.
A remodeling job? That's questionable, Jack, even for you. Why can't you just tell me the truth?
You're right. I can't lie to you. There was no remodeling job being done in my office. The truth is, it was being fumigated. Yes, that's it. And I was forced to leave until further notice.
Then what about all this? Huh? And this money? Tell me what all this money is for.
Diane, there's a perfectly rational explanation as to why there's a box of chocolates and an envelope with $300 addressed to Trixie sitting on the nightstand.
Then explain it to me, Jack. Explain to me what you could possibly need this kind of money for.
I ordered Chinese food.
$300 worth?
I was hungry.
Nobody can eat $300 worth of Chinese food, Jack. That is impossible.
Hello, Peking Palace. This is Jack Stevenson. I'd like to cancel my order, please. That is correct. Thank you, Trixie.
Well, now don't you feel foolish?
If you are telling me the truth, would you mind explaining to me why you have dozens of condoms on the bed? There is no way out of this one, Jack. You tell me, and you tell me now.
Diane, there's a perfectly rational explanation as to why there's a wide assortment of flavored condoms sitting on the bed.
I'm waiting.
They're yours.
Mine?
Or for you, rather. I purchased them earlier today. I was planning a special surprise by coming home and making love to you. Multiple times. I wanted to do something thoughtful for... Well, I suppose it doesn't matter now. Happy anniversary, Diane.
Oh, you expect me to believe that, Jack? Our anniversary isn't for 7 months. And what kind of husband buys condoms as an anniversary gift?
It's just like you to be ungrateful. You don't appreciate me, Diane. You never did.
Oh, don't you turn this around on me, Jack. That is nonsense. Clearly, you cannot be trusted. It's very obvious to me what is going on here.
Well, perhaps not everything is as it appears, Diane, including you.
And just what is that supposed to mean?
It's quite simple, really. Your constant paranoia, your ever-growing distrust of my activities. Suspicion haunts the guilty mind, as they say.
And just what on earth do I have to feel guilty about? Look, I don't know what you're getting at, Jack, but if you think that I'm
You're hiding something, Diane. You're hiding something. And now you're attempting to deflect the blame onto me in order to rid yourself of any lingering culpability.
Are you saying that I
created this entire scenario in your mind? I've been cheating on you and whatnot. Likely the result of a paranoid, repentant mentality. A guilty conscience, if you will. You're probably going to say that's ridiculous.
That's ridiculous!
I was afraid you might say that. You see, you've convinced yourself that I'm the Claudius to your Hamlet, the Brutus to your Caesar. I've never questioned your faithfulness, Diane, yet here you stand questioning mine. If you ask me, perhaps you're the one who can't be trusted.
Me?
Well, it stands to reason. It's simply your means of self-preservation. You'd go to great lengths to ensure your sovereignty, won't you? But at whose expense, Diane? Perhaps that's why you came here. You wanted to catch me, didn't you? Walk in on me having a lurid affair.
That is what happened, Jack. I caught you.
No, Diane. I caught you.
What?
You thought you were going to get away with it, didn't you? Misleading me into believing that I had forsaken you. You tried to play me for a fool, Diane. Well, I, for one, am not going to stand idly by and allow you to manipulate me after what you've done.
What I've done? What are you talking about?
I think that's rather clear. Why, it's as plain as the nose on your face. You've been cheating on me.
I've been cheating on you?
So you admit it then?
No, I've been
cheating on... Diana, a relationship is supposed to be based upon trust. Clearly that is something we do not have, you and I.
But I was...
If I cannot trust you, I don't know how we are expected to carry on a healthy relationship.
Jack, I'm
you're
just
You're proving
saying...
yourself to be untrustworthy. You're selfish, ungrateful, and you've made me feel less of a man. I don't know if I could ever forgive you for this, Diane.
Jack, it's just that when I walked in here, I thought
you
that
thought
you
thought nothing because you didn't think, did you?
But I was
Did
just...
you?
No. But I mean, based on the circumstances, surely you can't blame me for what
oh,
I thought...
Oh, come off it, Diane. Are you going to tell me that things haven't been different between you and I ever since your diagnosis?
My diagnosis?
Yes. Your diabetes. They've changed you. You're not the same woman I once loved. You've let yourself go, Diane. The truth is, I'm not attracted to you anymore.
But Jack.
I didn't want to do that, Diane. No man should ever hit a woman. But... You gave me no choice. I think you owe me an apology.
You're right. Sorry, Jack. I hope you can forgive
me. Silence! I think the best thing for you to do is leave.
Jack, I just...
You said your piece. It's time to go. And remember... You did this to us. And Diane, I hope you've learned your lesson.
I have, Jack.
Diane, wait. Don't take the condoms.
But I thought they were for me.
Were.
Knock, knock, knock. I didn't understand what you meant by your phone call, but my name is Trixie, and I'm here to show you a really good time. You must be Jack Stevenson.
Shit.